Most people recognize Jim Parsons from CBS's Big Bang Theory as the supremely intelligent yet stubbornly childish Sheldon Cooper. But if you think that he's anything like his nerdy on-screen persona, then think again. You might be surprised that Parsons has never seen an episode of Star Trek or Doctor Who, even though those are two of Sheldon's favorites. Parsons is far from the dorky, brooding goofball he played on TV. His personal life is rich with intricacy, complexity, and even a bit of mystery. More than just being a primary cast member, Parsons was the glue that held everything together for the Big Bang Theory. So much so that when he called it quits after season 12, the show itself followed suit and bowed out. But why did he make that fateful decision to leave the show when he did? Apparently, the circumstances surrounding his departure from the show were rather dark and intense. Find out the revealing truth about why Jim Parsons fell out of love with the show that turned him into a household name by watching this whole video. Facts First presents, Why Jim Parsons Quit the Big Bang Theory. Before we unravel that particular mystery, we're going to take a closer look at the life of Jim Parsons and uncover some little-known facts about one of television's most recognizable faces. Find out why Jim has never done American Horror Story despite being close buddies with Ryan Murphy, the horror series creator. Discover the heartbreaking secret that Parsons kept for years in fear that it would bring bad publicity to him and the show he was so loyal to. But first, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Tap the bell icon to turn on notifications so you never have to miss another one of our facts-filled videos. Jim Parsons appeared in 15 pilots before starring on The Big Bang Theory. Sure, you might know him as Sheldon Cooper, but Jim Parsons fought really hard to land the role that now seems so synonymous with his name. He wasn't just instantaneously successful. In fact, he wouldn't join the Big Bang cast until he was 33. Before that, he was working really hard to get his name out there. Leading up to landing the Big Bang part that would change his life forever, he had been a part of 15 failed pilots that never got off the ground. In fact, the same year as the Sheldon audition, he had tried out for several other shows and was turned away. Just goes to show you, perseverance pays off in the end. Jim misses Simon Helberg the most. Sheldon Cooper wasn't quite what you'd call a social butterfly, but he still managed to befriend Leonard. The two were best friends in every sense of the word. Sheldon was also really cozy with Penny. In the real world, Jim was actually friends with Kaley Cuoco and Johnny Galecki, the actors who played those two respective roles. What might come as a surprise, though, is who Jim says he'll miss the most now that the show has come to a close. On screen, Sheldon and Howard always seemed to be at odds with each other. Sheldon didn't think that Howard was a legitimate scientist, but off camera, Simon Helberg and Jim Parsons were quite close. They spent 12 years together and would have deep conversations on a regular basis in each other's dressing rooms. Simply put, they confided in each other in a special way that Parsons says he's going to feel the absence of in a large way as time goes on. Parsons has severe nerve issues. Despite being one of the most famous TV actors of our day, he would have intense bouts of nervousness and anxiety before each taping. Consistently, he would deliver the goods, pumping out unparalleled performances that wowed audiences and stunned producers, but he always had the fear in the back of his mind he would somehow forget all of his lines or otherwise do something equally embarrassing. Even the biggest names on television get a touch of stage fright sometimes. Jim Parsons powered through his, and we never even noticed. His acting teachers didn't think he had what it takes. Parsons received his training at the University of San Diego in their acting program. Despite Jim's passion to perform, the university had their doubts he could actually be a decent actor. Rick Sear from the university recalls Jim had what he called a very specific personality. He worried he might be too one-dimensional despite how uniquely original his persona was. The school was skeptical he could translate his acting ability to things like classic theater, but it looks like those concerns didn't hurt Parsons' career in the least bit. He went on to win 4 Primetime Emmy Awards and a Golden Globe Award for his role as Sheldon. He was afraid to discuss his sexuality. When the show was just getting its start, Parsons lived with the constant fear that if he were to openly discuss his sexuality, especially his orientation, that he might either bring unwanted publicity to himself or the show. He was loyal to the show and wanted to see it thrive, but he was also afraid of losing his job. He told The Hollywood Reporter recently it was hard for him to come out because when he was younger, the world was far less open. It wasn't exactly as accepting as it is today to people with non-heteronormative orientations. Being gay has changed. It's much easier to be out in this day and age. But that didn't stop the fears of his younger years from creeping into his adult and professional life. Despite his fears, he pushed through. In fact, in 2017, he married his partner Todd Spiewak. The two had been an item since 2002. In 2013, he and Todd would receive the GLSEN's Most Inspiring Couple Award, much to Parsons' surprise. He responded to the honor by saying he never expected to be viewed as an inspiration just for being in love. Why hasn't he been on American Horror Story? Ryan Murphy is the creator of American Horror Story. He and Jim are actually pretty decent friends. Murphy even cast Parsons in several of his other works in recent years, like the Netflix series Hollywood. When Jim called it quits on The Big Bang Theory, it was actually the Ryan Murphy-produced Broadway show Boys in the Band he was working on simultaneously. Murphy is well known for recasting folks he's previously worked with. So why hasn't he signed Jim up for the show that's now in its 10th season? In an interview with Collider, Jim explained that, quote, whether it was because of Big Bang or not, it had just never come up. He went on to express gratitude for getting to work with the esteemed producer on his other projects, and didn't count out the possibility of popping up on the hell-raising show eventually, but it had just never been a thing he and Murphy had discussed. Parsons learned to play the theremin for the show. Jim is actually a fairly skilled piano player, but there's no other instrument like the theremin. In case you're not familiar, the theremin is an instrument you play without touching. It consists of an antenna and a synthesizer modulation box. The closer you move your hand towards the antenna, the higher the pitch the instrument puts out. Since it's played entirely out of muscle memory, it's one of the more difficult instruments to learn. Despite the steep learning curve, he still figured out how to play it for the show, where Sheldon uses it as a way to distract himself while simultaneously annoying the living heck out of everyone. Bazinga. The term is one of Sheldon's trademark catchphrases. He often yells the exclamation when he successfully lands a prank or accomplishes a goal. The phrase became so popular it began to find its way off of the show and into the real world. The Bazinga bee, or Euglossa bazinga, is an endangered bee variety found in Brazil, and Bazinga reiki is a type of jellyfish. Both species of animals were named after Sheldon's catchphrase. Why did Jim call it quits on The Big Bang Theory? The Big Bang Theory enjoyed surprisingly decent ratings and viewership for all 12 seasons. It was during season 11, however, that Jim started feeling overwhelmed by everything that was on his plate. He was doing Big Bang and also working on Broadway, then there was a commercial project that he was also involved in. All these elements came to a head, and Parsons soon found himself exhausted. Then tragedy struck. Jim is an ardent animal lover. So when one of his dogs got very ill, had a severe seizure, and had to be put to sleep, he was absolutely devastated. He found himself in a foggy haze of depression. Then things got worse. While he was walking out for a curtain call for Boys in the Band, he slipped and broke his foot. He said it was one of the scariest moments of his life, and he felt as if he was sitting on the edge of a cliff for the following few days. That summer was especially troubling for Jim. He had had his dog since he was 14, so in many ways the passing of his pet felt like the end of an era. Reflecting on his father's death at the young age of 52, Parsons realized that life can be short, and it's what you make of it. So it was through the dark lens of mortality that Jim had a moment of clarity and knew it was time to wrap up his work on the show after 12 long years. There was no falling out, no contractual disputes, nothing like that. It was just his time to move on. When he told the network of his intention to continue on a different chapter of his life, they made no attempt to keep the show going without him. They made the decision to cancel the show that was still performing well because they knew it wouldn't be the same without him. Jim, we think you made the right decision. It's always a good idea to put your happiness first and not find yourself trapped in your work. It's actually kind of refreshing the network didn't try to keep milking the show after Jim left. Can you imagine what The Big Bang Theory would have been like without Sheldon? Would you still have watched it without him, or would you change the channel? Let us know what you think in the comments section. And before you leave, make sure to remember to hit like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already.